Hey everybody, Maury here again, and I want to do this quick video to explain to you the importance of knowing about carrier oils. And carrier oils is something you're going to hear a lot about, and sometimes it's confusing because essential oils are an oil and we're telling you to mix them with carrier oils. And this is why, guys. So let's give you, for an example, the three oils I have in front of me are copaiba, I have frankincense, and I have lavender. And these are the three oils that I normally use for my skin routine. And what I can do is maybe make an overnight beauty serum and roll it on my face every night, or I can make a more intense body moisturizer or an intensive moisturizer for my face. Now, if I were to get each of these oils and put them on my hand to put on my face every night, so here we go, I'm gonna put a drop of copaiba, okay? So now, as you can see, the copaiba is running through my fingers, I'm wasting it, and many of these oils evaporate quickly, so I have a lot of copaiba in my hand. I still need to put frankincense and lavender, and now I'm gonna try to put it on my face. Instead of trying to do that and wasting oils, what you can do is put like 5 drops of each in a roller bottle and fill it with the carrier oil, and then every night just roll it directly on your face. And the three essential oils are in there are evenly distributed and are going to go wherever that roller ball goes, okay? Same thing if you want to make a more intense moisturizer, whether it be for your body, a body butter, or for your face, you can put the essential oils in there, put them in a mixer for about 7 minutes with your coconut oil, and that way the oils evenly distribute, and wherever you apply it, all three of the essential oils touch that space. Now, basically it helps your carrier oils help your essential oils go further. It helps them go a longer way. These oils are a bit on the not so cheap side, and you wanna make sure you get the most bang for your buck and that you do not waste anything. So what are some of the essential oils that you can use? Let me move these out of the way. If you don't have anything in your home, you can use, let's start with olive oil. I have used olive oil in a pinch when I don't have anything else, and I use it, let's say if I need some immune support, I put these on a tablespoon maybe, with fill it up with olive oil and put like 3 or 4 drops of thieves, and then I put it on the bottom of my feet before I go to bed, and that's a good way of having immune support. Same thing if you wanna try some of the essential oils like lavender that help you sleep. What you can do is put a few drops of lavender on a spoon with some olive oil and put on the bottom of your feet, okay? Now, if you don't wanna smell like olive oil, you can do something like a fractionated coconut oil. You can buy this on Amazon or Whole Foods, any of your health food stores, and this does not have smell. Fractionated coconut oil is not to cook with. It is a carrier oil that you can use so that the essential oil goes in a bigger area in your body more effectively, okay? Now, there are other carrier oils. This coconut oil is the one that's the most common. You may see this at Publix or Winn-Dixie, wherever you shop for your grocery. And I love to get organic because it's the best one to have. But if I get the virgin one and not the refined coconut oil, what's going to happen is that my body is going to smell like a pina colada. Now, I love that in the summer. For those of you that know me, know that I'm a Keys girl. Well, I can't even open this bottle of coconut oil. Here we go. And it's solid form, okay? Now, I would not use this for my body butter, because if I use lavender lemon, I want my body butter to smell like lavender lemon. So instead of getting organic virgin, get organic refined. When you get refined, it already removes the coconut smell out. So when I use the body butter, if I make a body butter with lavender lemon, I am going to smell like lavender lemon and not like coconut, okay? Now, this is my all-time favorite. I only have a big bucket, I'm sorry. This is what I use for parties, but this is Nutiva. Nutiva organic coconut oil, and it is refined. This is the creamiest of all the coconut oils. You can buy in a container this big. You don't have to get one this big, but it's the creamiest. it comes out the creamiest when we're talking about making a body butter or a body cream, okay? Now there are other great carrier oils, including pomegranate, which is incredible for your skin. Vitamin E, if you wanna target certain areas, you can use a vitamin E carrier oil. You can also have jojoba, which is really good for your skin and for your hair. And then you can always purchase the Young Living V6 carrier oil. It's nothing but a simple carrier oil that you can add anything to. So for example, if I wanted to make my own perfume, and one of my favorite oils is Sarah or White Angelica or Lady Scalara. I love all those oils for perfume, for natural perfume. What I can do is get the V6 and fill it up and put 10 to 20 drops on a roller bottle. And then I have, my hands are really oily right now, but I open this up and I just put it on my wrist and on the back of my neck. And now I have a natural perfume, okay? So basically that's carrier oils and all the options that you have. There are a lot of them. And you want to use carrier oils because they're going to help your essential oils go a long way. I hope this video helps. As always, let us know if you have any questions and go to theroyalgroup.com on our website for more information. You can go to our Facebook page, The Royal Group, for more information as well. All right, if you have any questions, let us know.